nothing really excites me. Only one of me and nobody's like me. Phone ringing and I tell him it's pricey. I got wifey on bling and she icy. Freeze, photo, please, no photos. No, G's, no, please, no photos. Hit the door and the door and just whole team here, might need some.
Hey friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel and to my series where we turn the zodiac signs into their very own abstract paintings. Today we're channeling all things light and fun, getting inspired by witty Gemini. So, all of you Geminis out there watching today, I really hope I do you justice. Let's not waste any time. Geminis don't have long attention spans and neither do I. So, let's jump into the characteristics of Gemini that we'll be using as inspiration today. Number one, Gemini's symbol is the twins. Duality is their most commonly known trait. And this plays into everything that they do, from having multiple careers to multiple hobbies, multiple lovers, and just being the kinds of people that can really adapt and wear many different hats. This is also where they get their reputation for being two-sided or two-faced, when really this just means that Gemini is adaptable and can really socially thrive in different scenarios because they're kind of like chameleons in a lot of ways. They can adapt to their environment. And if they're around different personalities, they kind of mold to fit wherever they are and whoever they're with, which is why they're such an outgoing and sociable sign. They're also restless and lively because they have a lot of energy, and that's why they're usually the kind of people that work a 9-to-5 but then are also possibly influencers on the side. They're just really good at multiple different things. But to further understand their double-sided nature, you want to know a little bit more about the fact that number two, Gemini is a mutable air sign. This is where they get that adaptability. Being mutable means that they are likely to thrive when things are changing. And they're not afraid of that. They're not afraid of change. In fact, they welcome it with open arms. They're great at being put on the spot and shifting to new experiences. They're highly intellectual because they are air signs. Air signs are very intelligent. They use that to their advantage in their writing, in their music, in anything that they do creatively. They're so gifted at exchanging ideas and persuading people of their values and beliefs. I automatically think of James Charles, who is a very famous Gemini. He's an influencer, a businessman, and he thrives in all of these different areas of his life, and he's a master communicator. It's what he does for a living. He talks really quickly and he engages with his audience very easily. He really is the king of Geminis in a lot of ways, or the perfect example of someone who's built to be in the public eye, which Geminis often are. But because they can exchange ideas with people so easily and communicate and kind of adapt, that's where people get the idea that Geminis are fake, that people think they aren't showing their true colors. And in a way that is kind of true. Geminis definitely keep their true selves kind of hidden. And to really get to the core of a Gemini, you have to know them really well. They'd rather not go too deep. Because there's that twin element, the two sides, I'm gonna really play into that duality. And in my painting, I think I'm gonna use two different color palettes, sort of the lighter greens and purples I imagine, you know, the like really bubbly colors that Gemini represents. Those are gonna be up top or on the left, I'm not quite sure yet, but I'm gonna have them in contrast with some of the darker blacks and darker purples that also coincide with Gemini's color palette, as if the lighter colors are almost trying to hide that darkness. And last but not least, Gemini is ruled by the planet Mercury. And Mercury was named after the messenger of the gods. This is the planet of communication, and I really can't hit home hard enough how intelligent and communicative Geminis are. They have a way with words, and there's just no getting around that. They're so witty and charming. Any career in communications is built for King and Queen Gemini. With all that being said, if you want to see how Gemini's painting comes to life today, definitely stick around, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe, and keep watching to see what we can do with this.
You and I, we never show emotions, we just keep it down, down inside. Yeah, you and I, both longing for expression for the things we like, but we stay quiet. Hold me now, hold me now. Tell me things, tell me all about how you feel. Just let yourself go. Say it loud, say. yourself go. Just let go.
Guys, here is the final result for Gemini. My main goal for this was to kind of showcase that twin element of Gemini by playing off the green and purple contrasts. The green representing some of that light, playful, and charming quality, and the purple representing the deeper side Gemini might keep hidden. I just really wanted this to be as vibrant and fun as possible with lots of little details to spend time with, and yeah, I wanted it to kind of look like a dance or a party and to capture that natural charm and outgoing quality Gemini represents. If you enjoyed this video and you think I did Gemini justice today with my painting, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more, because I'm going to be doing all the Zodiac paintings and I'm already working on Cancer, so I'm so excited to tap into that. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Bye!